Hi, I'm Matt Warder, Director of Research here at Money Map Press, and I want to talk to you today about the most controversial investment of the past 100 years. I'm talking about Bitcoin. Now, over the last year, we've heard every single angle about the Bitcoin story. Some people say it's the salvation of the global economy. Other people say it's a complete scam. With all that noise, it's virtually impossible for the average investor to know what to do and what to think. So today, I'm here to tell you to forget everything you've ever heard about Bitcoin because I'm going to lay out one simple fact. In 2010, Bitcoin was trading for 3/10 of a penny. That means you could have bought 100 Bitcoin for just 30 cents. In 2019, Bitcoin was trading for $13,800. That means the same 30 cents you put in Bitcoin in 2010 was worth $1.38 million just 9 years later. For 30 cents, that's for a quarter and a nickel, you could have been a millionaire. For $3, the price of a cup of coffee, you could have made over $10 million. For the cost of dinner out with your significant other, you could have made over $250 million. And for $1,500 invested in Bitcoin in 2010, you would have been number 76 on Forbes' list of the 100 richest billionaires in America. And that's assuming you held on through Bitcoin's so-called crash. If you sold at Bitcoin's all-time high, that same $1,500 investment would have made you the 46th richest billionaire in America. No other investment in the history of the world has offered that kind of return. Actually, the only investment that comes close are other cryptocurrencies. Because since Bitcoin first launched, Litecoin returned 33,709%. Ripple returned 136,944%. Ethereum returned 340,258%. So $200 into each of those coins would have returned $1,021,000. There can be no dispute of the millionaire-making potential cryptocurrencies enjoyed for the last decade. The only question is what happens now? So to answer that, we've invited our Director of Technology and Venture Capital Research, Michael Robinson. Michael, good to have you.
Great to be with you again, Matt.
Now, Michael, you're one of the earliest backers of Bitcoin I know. You were on networks like Fox Business and CNBC in 2013 talking about Bitcoin. You were one of the first people I know to have held a cryptocurrency summit over 6 years ago where over 100,000 people were welcome to attend. You laid out simple strategies that could have netted phenomenal 25,351% gains at the peak, turning a $10,000 investment into more than $2.5 million. Needless to say, people who listened to you could have made a fortune. So I have one question for you, Michael. If Bitcoin really is the greatest investment in human history and all these numbers are real and people really could have turned $1,500 into billions, then why don't we see more crypto billionaires walking around?
You know, Matt, the answer is really very simple. People did walk away making a fortune. It just wasn't billions. Now, you need to understand that in 2010, Bitcoin was trading for 3/10 of a penny. Now, that's 100 Bitcoin for just 30 cents. Back then, almost no one believed in it. The first wave of people to get rich off Bitcoin were young, broke students. Let's take Steve Johnson, for example. He started buying Bitcoin when it was at 20 cents. He later sold his Bitcoin when it hit $258, Matt. Now, he cashed out with more than $30 million in profit. Or take Jack Snyder, a recent college graduate. He started investing in Bitcoin when it was at just 15 cents, Matt. And a few short years later, Jack made over $25 million in profit. Or how about Eric Green? He started investing in Bitcoin when he was 13 years old.
13 is pretty impressive.
It really is. Listen, when I was 13 years old, I was changing light bulbs for a buck an hour. And Matt, by the time he was 19, Eric Green was a millionaire. Now, as you can see, none of these young men became actual billionaires.
I bet they'd wish they'd hung on a little longer, right?
Yeah, well, you can look at it that way. You can look back on it and say, boy, it was dumb for them to sell early. But you have to understand, these kids were broke and barely scraping by. So they're going to cash out and take their millions now instead of waiting to become billionaires. So that was the first wave of Bitcoin millionaires. Then came the second wave. These were mostly tech geeks in Silicon Valley who understood the technological potential of Bitcoin, like Mike Adams. He was working in the tech industry in the mid-2010s and slowly accumulated Bitcoin. By 2017, Mike was a millionaire and was able to quit his full-time job.
And that's what it's all about, right? Being financially secure enough that you never have to work a day in your life.
That's exactly right, Matt. Now, another man, Matt Wright, started his own tech company. Then, in 2015, an investor offered to buy his company for 300 Bitcoin, which was worth about $300 per Bitcoin at the time. Matt took the offer, and by 2017, he amassed more than $2.5 million in Bitcoin. Another man, Sam Abraham, actually got his first job at a Bitcoin exchange website. Instead of accepting his salary in US dollars, he accepted it in Bitcoin. By 2017, he had made millions. He then started his own crypto hedge fund, which he grew to over $300 million in assets, Matt.
Right, the second wave of Bitcoin millionaires.
That's exactly right. But here's the good news, Matt. Thanks to a special set of circumstances that has never existed before, Bitcoin is about to enter into its third wave. And we are already seeing the very beginnings of it. Bitcoin has spiked more than 334% in 2019. And mark my words, Matt, it's just getting started. And once it does, it's going to create a whole new group of millionaires.
So, Michael, what's happening in 2020 that's causing that?
Well, Matt, there are several things that are going on all at the same time in 2020 that have never existed before. The first thing is the massive amount of money flowing into Bitcoin securities. For example, take Bitcoin futures contracts. Bitcoin futures is a red-hot market. In March of 2019, there were more than $1.8 billion in Bitcoin futures contracts. 1 month later, that number shot up to $5.5 billion.
Wow, so you're saying it tripled in 30 days.
That's exactly right. And you know what else happened the next month, Matt? More than $12 billion traded in Bitcoin futures. That's more than $10.2 billion flowing into Bitcoin futures in just 2 months. Keep in mind, Matt, Bitcoin futures in 2017 barely existed. But Bitcoin futures aren't the only thing sending Bitcoin's price skyrocketing. Hedge funds are also loading up on Bitcoin thanks to its massive returns. In fact, one of the top-performing hedge funds of 2019 has over half their portfolio in Bitcoin, while the average hedge fund returned 5.7% in the first half of 2019. This Bitcoin-heavy hedge fund returned a whopping 46%.
Wow, so 46% in 6 months. Those types of returns are just unheard of in the hedge fund space.
That's right, Matt. Big institutional money is just flowing into Bitcoin. But listen, Bitcoin is not the only cryptocurrency benefiting from this huge influx of money. These are special coins called specific use coins, Matt, that are producing rare and exceptional returns. Specific use coins are very similar to Bitcoin. Now, the main difference here is that they are much smaller than Bitcoin, and they were created for a very specific technological purpose. Take Egretia. Egretia is a specific use coin used for website development. Its market cap is much, much smaller than Bitcoin. But just take a look at this chart of Egretia from March to July of 2019. Egretia shot up 23,032%. Turning a $500 investment into $115,000 in just 4 months. And that's just one specific use coin, Matt.
Right. That sounds pretty unique. Like if people didn't know about it, they'd just miss the boat.
Actually, Matt, here's the good news. There are thousands of these. Take Atlantis Blue Digital Token. This is a specific use coin used in mining operations. Now, look at the chart here. Atlantis Blue Digital Token increased 15,572% from April to June. That's like turning $500 into $77,000 in just 2 months. Or take Agave coin. This specific use coin is used in agave production. It increased 14,277% from January to August, turning $500 into $71,000 in just 8 months. Or take XMAX, another specific use coin. Get this. In just 7 days, Matt, XMAX increased 1,675%. That's like turning $500 into $8,375 in just a week.
Wow, $8,000 in a week is phenomenal.
It sure is. But XMAX wasn't alone, Matt. Take a look at Themis. This coin went straight up over the course of 4 days, giving folks a 572% return. That's almost seven times your money in just 4 days. And then there's ClipperCoin. ClipperCoin, Matt, gave investors a quick, easy 936% return in just 2 days, turning $500 into $4,680 in just 48 hours. And then there's Commerce Data Connections. This coin shot up 1,262% in just 3 days, turning $500, Matt, into $6,300 in under 72 hours.
Wow, that's a huge return and fast, too. Michael, I can't think of any investment that's done that.
That's because there is no other investment giving you these kinds of returns, Matt. But the question is, why now? Why are Bitcoin and these specific use coins exploding in value? Well, Matt, the answer is simple. There's a little-known pattern behind every technological breakthrough to ever exist. The pattern has three stages. The first stage, Matt, is the early adopter stage. This is the stage where almost nobody knows the technology exists outside of a few insiders. It's so brand new, it's barely even a concept. This was the internet back in the days when it was only used by the government and universities, or cell phones back in the 1980s.
Or like Bitcoin back in 2010.
Exactly, Matt. The second stage of any technology is the massive consolidation stage. This is where the market contracts and low-performing competitors start going under or get acquired. In this stage, you always see massive price declines. For example, you might remember the dot-com boom of the late 1990s. Tech stocks in the NASDAQ were going crazy. The market was ripe for massive consolidation. That's why the NASDAQ came tumbling down in the early 2000s. But then, after consolidation, comes the third stage, the expansion stage. In the expansion stage, you start to see massive amounts of money flow into the industry, usually from big banks and other smart money investors. This is exactly what happened after the dot-com consolidation. Here, let's take a look at the chart of the NASDAQ. So you see the dot-com boom here, that's stage one. Then you see the massive consolidation right here, that's stage two. But what happens immediately after is the expansion stage. You see tons of money flowing in like never before, creating unprecedented wealth. Matt, this is the phase that creates billionaires.
Which is incredibly exciting. Michael, if you wouldn't mind, could you give us some examples?
Sure. Let's start with Bill Gates. He was worth $315 million in 1986, but after the home computers and Microsoft entered their expansion phase, Bill Gates' net worth skyrocketed to over $85 billion. That means more than 99% of his wealth came from the expansion stage of computers. Or take Jeff Bezos, currently the richest man in the world. In Amazon's early days in 1998, his net worth was $1.6 billion. You know, not bad. But then online shopping and delivery entered into its expansion phase in the 2000s. And now his net worth is over $113 billion.
Well, before his recent divorce.
That's for sure. But again, over 99% of Jeff Bezos' wealth came after the expansion stage of online shopping and delivery. Or take visionary genius Steve Jobs. In 1978, his net worth was over $250 million. At the time of his death, Jobs was worth over $11 billion. That's a 44 times increase during the expansion phase. As you can see, more than 99% of the richest people in the world's wealth came from the expansion phase. And now with Bitcoin going into the expansion phase...
Right, you're saying we're going to see the next Bill Gates, the next Steve Jobs, the next Jeff Bezos.
That's exactly right, Matt. That's why Bitcoin shot up more than 334% in 2019. It's at the very beginning of its expansion phase. Money is flowing into Bitcoin like never before. And by all accounts, it looks like it's far from over. But it's not just Bitcoin benefiting from the expansion phase, Matt. Many of the other specific use coins are exploding in value as well. Just look at some of these rare and extraordinary returns, like BlockCDN. BlockCDN increased 3,286% from March 14th to April 1. That's like turning $500 into $16,400 in just 18 days.
Fantastic. So are there others we should take a look at here?
Well, Matt, take Global Boost Y. That shot up 5,068% also in just 18 days. That would have turned $500 into $25,400 in under 3 weeks. Or take Beetlecoin, Matt. That shot up 3,193% between January and March. That turns $500 into just under $16,000 in 2 months. Or take Equal. That shot up 5,239% between April and June. That's turning $500 into over $26,000 in 2 months. Or take Litex. That shot up 2,605% between February and August, turning $500 into $13,000 in just 6 months.
Wow. You know, returns like those are hard to come by, but the expansion phase you're talking about sounds like it could create a lot of those opportunities. Can you talk a little bit about that expansion phase? Like, what exactly is happening there?
You know, Matt, I mentioned billions and billions of dollars are flowing into these coins like never before, usually from institutional smart money investors like hedge funds. But that's not the only factor at play here. One of the biggest indicators of an expansion phase is mass market adoption. In other words, are millions and millions more people using this technology that have never used it before? This happens with every single technology. Take cell phones, for example. I mean, Matt, back in the 1980s, almost no one had a cell phone.
Right, because they used to be enormous.
Yeah, it's like carrying a brick around, right? And not only that, they were very, very expensive. But then in the 1990s, you started to see mass market adoption of cell phones. Millions of people started buying them. And stock prices of cell phone manufacturers went through the roof. Take Motorola, one of the biggest cell phone manufacturers in the world. In 1983, when Motorola released their first major cell phone, their stock price was $8.14. But by 2000, after the mass adoption of cell phones, their price hit a whopping $222 per share. That's a 2,602% increase, which could have turned $1,000 into $26,000. Take the invention that completely disrupted the cell phone industry, smartphones. Apple released the first iPhone back in 2007. Their share price at the time was $11.70.
Right, but now smartphones are everywhere. Almost everyone has one.
Exactly, Matt. And now Apple's share price is over $245. That's a 1,994% increase, or like turning $1,000 into $19,900. And remember, Apple was already a huge company before the iPhone came out. That's the power of mass adoption, Matt. And now we're seeing this exact market adoption happening with Bitcoin. Bitcoin as a payment system has grown by leaps and bounds in 2019. For example, AT&T just started accepting Bitcoin as payment for its 150 million customers this May.
Right, and 150 million customers, that adds a ton of demand.
It sure does, Matt. And keep in mind, the telecom industry as a whole is worth $2.4 trillion. You also have Microsoft, with more than $125 billion in revenue, now accepting Bitcoin as payment. In fact, Bill Gates is on record as saying Bitcoin is better than currency. Then you have satellite provider Dish Network accepting Bitcoin for its 10 million subscribers. That industry is worth another $90 billion. Amazon even started accepting Bitcoin at Whole Foods locations just a few months ago. The grocery store industry, Matt, is worth another $5.75 trillion. And there are rumors Amazon could start accepting Bitcoin on their main website, too. That means for the first time ever, a potential $8.36 trillion worth of industry is adopting Bitcoin.
Right. There's so much development coming that it's like we're in the second or third inning of a nine-inning baseball game.
That's right, Matt. Back in 2017, the only companies that accepted Bitcoin as payment were either doing it as a joke or as a PR stunt. But now you're seeing mass adoption by major blue-chip companies. But that's not the only reason for Bitcoin's massive rise, Matt. It goes much deeper than that. There are also billions and billions of dollars flowing into Bitcoin as an investment vehicle. See, smart money is flowing into Bitcoin from hedge funds to banks to venture capitalists. For example, institutions like investing in funds and trusts related to Bitcoin. One of the most popular is the Grayscale Bitcoin Trust. Between the first and second quarter of this year, total investments in this fund increased from $927 million to $2.7 billion. That's over a $1.7 billion increase in one Bitcoin trust in just 3 months. And here's the kicker, Matt. Grayscale says that institutions made up more than 84% of this increase. Keep in mind, Matt, that the 2017 Bitcoin rally had nothing to do with institutions. The rise of Bitcoin in 2017 was led by speculative investors.
Right, but now that's completely changed.
Indeed it has, Matt. Here's the thing. It's almost all institutions at this point. Guys who were sitting on the sidelines in 2017 are now diving headfirst into Bitcoin. And if you want definitive proof that this is true, look no further than the United States government. Why, Matt? Because when big institutions start investing in something like Bitcoin, they want to invest in an environment that's safe and comfortable for their investing style. Institutions don't want to be trading on Bitcoin exchanges based in third world countries that directly control their billions of dollars. They want the U.S. government to come in and set up some rules and regulations. And Matt, now that the institutions want Bitcoin, they are heavily lobbying the federal government to take action, which is why the federal government has drastically changed its tune on Bitcoin over the past few months. In fact, Republican Senator Mike Crapo from Idaho said in July, "I believe that the U.S. should lead in developing Bitcoin and what the rules of the road should be." If a Republican senator from Idaho is suddenly supporting Bitcoin, I don't know how much more proof you need that things are changing and changing quickly. But in case you do need more proof, our Republican Senate is not the only group supporting Bitcoin.
Right. You mentioned the other day that the IRS is getting involved too. Could you tell us a little bit more about that?
Glad to, Matt. Now, up until this point, Bitcoin and all cryptocurrencies existed in a gray area for the IRS. Our current rules and regulations don't properly address Bitcoin like they do with stocks and bonds, but that's about to change. In May, IRS Commissioner Charles Rettig said the IRS will soon publish a new tax guidance for virtual currencies. In other words, Matt, Bitcoin and other specific use coins are about to become fully legitimized in the eyes of the IRS. Keep in mind, this is the first time in the history of the IRS that they have acknowledged Bitcoin. The IRS is laying the rules in place for literally trillions of dollars to flow into Bitcoin that was never there before, Matt.
Which sounds like it's going to be a huge help for the industry. Is there anything else coming out of Washington?
You know, I'm glad you asked that, Matt. Even the Federal Reserve is dropping hints about Bitcoin playing a prominent role in the future of the United States. Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell said he can envision a return to an era where multiple currencies are in use in the United States. All of this, Matt, the institutional money, the mass adoption, the federal government's support and regulations all point to one thing.
Right. Bitcoin is back and it's here to stay.
That's exactly right. You know, it's about to enter into an expansion phase, potentially creating billions and billions of dollars in new wealth. That's why I'm predicting Bitcoin could hit $250,000 in the next 3 years. And it's not just me saying this, Matt. Just listen to some of these estimates from institutional leaders with billions of dollars in assets. Venture capitalist Tim Draper, who famously made billions investing in Tesla, Twitter, Hotmail, and many other tech companies, predicts Bitcoin to hit $250,000. And world-renowned hedge fund Ventura Capital predicts Bitcoin to hit $356,000 by 2021. And former Goldman Sachs executive Raul Powell calculates Bitcoin's market cap, which currently sits at around $200 billion, is set to hit over $8 trillion. But here's the thing, Matt. As much as I like Bitcoin, I believe Bitcoin's gains are going to be minuscule compared to the gains from smaller, specific use coins. I have already shown you countless examples of specific use coins skyrocketing in 2019. But let me go into detail about one of my favorites. It's called Thorcoin. This coin is amazing because its value is based on a collection of other highly traded coins, kind of like a mutual fund.
So a specific use coin that acts like a mutual fund? That sounds tailor-made for institutional investors like hedge funds.
It really is. Just take a look at Thorcoin's chart for 2019. On February 18th, Thorcoin was trading for just 32 cents. Just 4 days later, Matt, it hit $141. That's a 43,000% increase in just 4 days.
Wow, unbelievable.
I know. But wait, Matt, there's actually more. On March 18th, just 1 month after Thorcoin was trading for 32 cents, it hit $554. That means your 43,000% winner is now a 169,000% winner. In other words, $100 worth of Thorcoin is now $169,000 after just 1 month.
Which is a once-in-a-lifetime investment.
Well, you would think that's the end of the story, right? But Thorcoin was just getting started, Matt. By May 18th, Thorcoin hit $1,151. And then by July 10th, get this, Matt, it hit $2,018. That's a 617,000% return in less than 5 months, turning $500 into more than $3,086,000.
Right. And we're going through these charts right now together. But if we weren't, I probably wouldn't believe you.
Well, I understand where you're coming from, Matt. This is why these specific use coins are so exciting right now. And here is the very best part. You don't need to catch the very bottom and get out at the very top to get rich. Now, let's go back to Thorcoin, for example. Let's say instead of getting in at 32 cents, you got in at $20. And let's say instead of getting out at $2,000, you got out at $1,500. That's still a 7,400% increase in just a few months, or turning $500 into $37,500.
Which is still an unbelievable return. So, Michael, what are your thoughts on diversification here? Because obviously all investments carry a risk of loss.
Good point, Matt. You know, we don't own a crystal ball, and not all investments work out as planned. That's exactly why you don't want to bet the farm on any one investment. But listen to this, Matt. With a 7,400% return, that means you can invest in 50 random specific use coins, and even if 49 of them fail, just one coin can make up for all of those losses and make you a fortune. But what I'd rather do is invest in 10 coins, and if things work out, have 8 of them make 1,000% or more, and 2 of them not pan out.
costs.
Right. And if one or two of them don't pan out, that's okay, because there are another seven or eight that could be poised for gains of 900, 1,000%, giving you a great portfolio with a really solid return. And that makes me want to talk to you about your approach here. When you and I chatted earlier, you mentioned you developed a specialized strategy for trading these specific use coins. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Happy to do so, Matt. It's called the Peak Profit Strategy. I used the Peak Profit Strategy when I first recommended Bitcoin when it was trading for just $90. I used that strategy to ride that wave all the way up to potential 25,000% returns. Now, I've worked for 7 years with nearly every top executive in the crypto space, and this has allowed me to work out the ideal time to target the maximum profits for these specific use coins. Like I said before, Matt, I previously used that strategy to help my readers get the chance at a 25,000% winner on Bitcoin.
Right, and because of the expansion phase we've been talking about, you think this is a really good time to get in?
I sure do, Matt. I still have high hopes for Bitcoin. I think it makes a great long-term investment, but I want to apply that same strategy to three of my very favorite specific use coins. That's why I've created a special profit report. It's called Three Specific Use Coins Set for 87,400%, 143,000%, and 289,250% explosions. You see, Matt, there are now more than 1,600 specific use coins to choose from.
Which is a huge number. And that makes me want to ask you about the quality of some of those coins.
You know what? Excellent question, Matt. Frankly, a lot of them just are not worth our time. And anyone who has paid attention knows the digital coin market is volatile, with some coins skyrocketing one day and crashing the next. The sad fact is, some investors will lose everything because they don't understand how to play this market correctly. To be blunt, Matt, they just don't know what they're doing. But if you know what to look for in these specific use coins, you could be lining up the biggest gains you'll ever see. Investing just $100, Matt, could give you a shot at a $87,400, $143,000, or even a $289,250 payday. Now, make no mistake, Matt, these types of gains are rare, but we've seen it happen before where everyday investors strike it rich from these specific use coins.
Right. You know, it may be rare, but you'd be kicking the hell out of yourself if you missed out on something like that.
That's right, Matt, which is why I've spent the last several weeks poring over these lesser-known specific use coins. I've looked hard at what solutions they provide, which industries truly benefit from them, and how they could grow and then sustain that growth. I've run them through all of my five-step filtering system and narrowed them down to just three that I believe are capable of being big, oversized, profit-making plays. These are three that you need to consider acting on, because right now they are positioning to match the kinds of peak profits, Matt, we've seen from the hottest specific use coins, like these. The first comparison you see, Matt, is ASH. It started trading at less than 2 cents a coin. If you'd purchased 5,000 coins, your $100 investment hit $6,371 at its peak. The next comparison is BitConnect, a specific use coin that climbed higher and higher for a head-shaking 309,185% profit. Matt, your $100 investment would have made you $300,000 richer at its peak. Or leap ahead to the Fastcoin and Sprouts comparisons. Both turned into 10 baggers in about a month's time. And I want you to have my expert strategy for trading the hottest new specific use coins that have this kind of potential so that you could be pocketing $5,000, $15,000, or even $40,000 a week every week. So for attendees today, Matt, I'm sharing the three best specific use coins to consider buying right now.
And you're going to show folks who joined us today how to get this profit report free in just a few minutes, right after we're done here, correct?
Yes, but before I do, I'm going to add one more profit report to the stack, because this one may be the most important of all. Let's face it, Matt, the world of cryptocurrencies can feel, well, for lack of a better term, intimidating. So much is so new and so different. So I've put together a quick course. It's called Becoming a Crypto Millionaire, Hands-On Instruction Starting from Square One. Matt, I literally start investors at square one, just like the title says, and I make everything as easy as opening a bank account and depositing money. I'm going to give you all of the basics from A to Z. You'll learn the history of cryptos, how they work, and why they're important.
Right. You'll be taking folks step by step, like how to buy, store, and sell them, which sounds pretty helpful. Can you elaborate a little bit?
I'm happy to, Matt. See, I'll even go into length on the differences between the major cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin, Ethereum, and a slew of others. And for those who have an interest, I'll show you how to trade them every day so you could make huge gains. I'll also show you how to avoid fees, help you avoid commissions, and this is very important, I'm going to give you some useful tax tips. There are some very important things every investor needs to know about taxes and cryptos, and some very nice loopholes I can show you as well, so that you can legally keep a majority of your earnings. In a few minutes with this, you'll have the hands-on instructions you need to master all things crypto-related. And Matt, in a very short time, you could be a crypto millionaire yourself. These guys are going to answer all of your questions, and again, starting from square one.
Well, that's good, because probably the most common question new investors in the space have is, how hard is this to do?
And that's a great question, Matt. You know what? The truth is, it is surprisingly easy to trade cryptos if you have the right investing guide in your corner. And that's exactly why we're having this summit right now. And it's also why I've put together this package to make it simple so that ordinary folks really can become crypto millionaires.
You know, Michael, people also wonder, how hard is it to open an account? And how hard is it to sell your coins when you want to?
Well, again, the trading exchanges have made it just as easy to buy and sell cryptocurrencies as opening a regular stock trading account. There are only a few steps, and I walk you through them each and every step of the way.
Right. Now, some people think you're buying some kind of physical coin when you invest, but that's not the case at all, right?
Well, it certainly sounds like that, and I can understand why people feel that way. But the coin is actually digital money. All of this is covered in the report. Fact is, you don't need to know anything about cryptos themselves to succeed. Of course, everyone should spend at least a little time reading up on the background of cryptos and why they're so in demand right now. But make no mistake, Matt, this report will give you all the tools you need. It really says it all in the title, Hands-On Instructions Starting from Square One.
Which is really amazing, Michael. I mean, here you are, you're one of the earliest adopters and buyers of Bitcoin, and now you've outlined all of these incredible opportunities in your profit reports. You're giving folks the basics of getting started buying and trading cryptos, the tax implications, everything. So how do folks listening today get these profit reports and your full crypto startup guide downloaded to their computers?
Well, Matt, I'm doing something very special. I want to give folks listening today a chance to get my two profit reports for free. All I ask is that they join me in a unique initiative I've started called the Nova X Report.
Okay, for folks listening who don't yet know, Nova X Report is one of the best tech research services out there. It's focused on tiny, little-known companies on the verge of breaking out. These companies could be involved in any of the big tech trends you follow every day, like big data, advanced robotics, genomics, immunotherapy, and other life-changing biotechnologies. 3D sensors, the Internet of Everything, miracle materials like graphene, driverless cars, the list goes on and on. And your track record, Michael, is unbelievable. I have it sitting in front of me here. In your closed portfolio across all your research services, you've given your subscribers 192 double-digit and triple-digit winners, including gains of 264% on NVIDIA, 213% on Broadcom, 400% on Square, 178% on E-Trade, 107% on Viva Systems, 293% on Corvo, 300% on SEO, 121% on Universal Display, 112% on Shopify, 111% on Skyworks Solutions, and 100% on Immunomedics, just to name a few. Now, I should mention for transparency that not all of your picks have been winners, Michael, which is just not possible in the markets. I mean, no one has a crystal ball.
You're right, but I would put that track record up against anyone's in the blink of an eye.
Well, I would too. Now, Michael, explain the role Nova X Report plays in everything we talked about today. How does this fit in with what you're doing here?
Well, Matt, that's an excellent question, and I'm glad you asked it. With the Nova X Report, I'm looking for small companies that have a stranglehold. Now, this could be a technology, a medical treatment, a process innovation. If this gives them a stranglehold on a sector with billions of dollars of potential, that's what I'm looking for. The Nova X Report takes folks behind the curtain, so to speak, so they can tap into the greatest source of individual wealth creation in the history of the human race.
Right. Inventions, innovation, things like that.
That's exactly right, Matt. Just like Bitcoin and specific use coins, with the Nova X Report, I deliver little-known opportunities that come straight from Silicon Valley. It's essentially me opening up my Rolodex from decades spent in the heart of Silicon Valley and giving members up-close access to my network to reveal the very most lucrative opportunities. Now, we're talking anything from drones, breakthrough supercomputing chips, 3D bioprinting. I've targeted ground floor opportunities in all of these areas. I even showed my NovaX members a way to acquire ownership stakes under very special terms in 30 of the hottest privately held pre-IPO companies in the world today. I'm talking about companies like Lyft, Spotify, DocuSign, Hytale, Tentry, and Cloudera. This deal, Matt, had the potential to pay off in huge multiples. We're talking 200-fold or better. I gave my subscribers simple step-by-step instructions for executing a partnership buy-in. The company even provided an exclusive phone line just for them. Since introducing this opportunity, Matt, one of the holdings has IPO'd for $1.1 billion and another has been bought out for $425 million in cash.
Right. And I should add here, you're no stranger to controversial investments. Sometimes your research reports, what you call deal dossiers, target some pretty interesting things. Am I right?
Well, that's true, Matt. And that's exactly what happened in 2016. I made an announcement that caused the heads of some folks out here in Silicon Valley to explode. I declared that every American needs to go all in on marijuana. I didn't care that it was illegal on a federal level. I didn't care that a lot of people saw it as a taboo. None of that mattered. This was about making money, plain and simple. And I had recently met with one of the most influential behind-the-scenes power brokers in the marijuana business today. He confirmed what I was hearing from my sources. The venture capital money was going to come roaring into this industry. And Matt, I wanted to make sure the folks following me had a chance at beating those venture capital big shots to the punch. So that September, I released a special report with all of my research on 30 pot stocks. In the months that followed, every single one of them hit peak positive gains.
Wow, and I can say from personal experience that having a streak like that where you got a 100% win rate is pretty rare.
Well, thanks, Matt. But even better is the fact that 17 soared into triple digits. Mentor Capital shot up as much as 1,828% in less than 6 months. InMed Pharmaceuticals, 617% in 4 months. General Cannabis Corp, 642% in a month and a half. Canagrow, 456% in the same amount of time. I was thrilled to see letters coming in from folks who followed my recommendations. That's what's possible when you are a member of the NovaX Report. But that's just the tip of the iceberg, Matt. For NovaX members, I've also created a unique program called the Crypto Circle. It's a very hands-on approach. You're going to get weekly updates as well as a monthly report to follow up on all of the big trends and news shaping the exciting and lucrative world of cryptocurrencies.
So, Michael, tell us a little bit more about the Crypto Circle. What does that mean exactly?
You know what? Let me give you an example, a perfect one of what I'm talking about. I can get readers cutting-edge analysis direct from a literal who's who in the crypto markets. Here's what I'm talking about, Matt. My team and I recently flew in Dr. Gavin Wood from his offices in Europe so he could give us the inside scoop on Ethereum. Dr. Wood happens to be the brilliant scientist and co-developer of Ethereum, one of the hottest cryptocurrencies out there right now. I sat down for an hour-long video interview with Dr. Wood, and he revealed some unbelievable things you just can't find anywhere else. He knows of one foreign government that could soon announce they'll conduct much of their international trade in Ethereum. That could result in as much as $578.6 billion flowing into this digital currency.
And that's the kind of direct access folks get when they're in your crypto circle.
You know, Matt, that's a good point. We regularly talk with the operators of the crypto trading exchanges, with the entrepreneurs bringing out new cryptos, with the financial people who are planning moves that can ratchet up prices. The information our guests share may never make it to the wide coverage and mainstream media, but as a member of the crypto circle, you'll be fully inside, fully briefed, fully prepared for each new climb to another higher specific use coin peak.
Which is great because information on these coins is really hard to come by. And I know because I've looked. So I can say the package you've put together here is amazing. So how can attendees get their shot at these kinds of profits starting today? Can you tell us about becoming a NovaX Report subscriber and participating in the crypto circle?
Glad to. You know, Matt, I'm a combination of old school and new school. I stay in regular email contact with our members, and I communicate by mail as well. Once a month, there's a newsletter with two new investment recommendations, real breakthrough opportunities like we've enjoyed previously with, say, miracle materials like graphene, 3D bioprinting, hypersonic engines, and so many more big plays we first broke. Then each week, I'll send a NovaX intelligence briefing, keeping folks up to speed on anything new, product launches, earnings reports, the latest gains in our model portfolio. And when it's time to take profits off the table, you'll get an instant trade alert.
Right. And you've got a website, a central repository where everything's stored, correct?
That's right, Matt. Our exclusive website is for members only. It hosts every briefing, every investment recommendation, and all of my alerts. And if members have any questions with their subscription, there's a NovaX VIP concierge service ready to help them. So, Matt, let's recap. You have my personal invitation to join me at the NovaX Report with 12 monthly issues, weekly progress reports, exclusive website access with all of the research and past issues. Plus, you'll also gain access to my special Crypto Circle with all of its insights and trading strategies. And all of this, Matt, is regularly priced at $299.
Right, but the great thing, Michael, is today, attendees of this summit won't have to pay anywhere near that amount, will they?
Well, Matt, today I'm authorizing something very special just for our attendees here. This is something I haven't done before, but this investing opportunity, it's just too big to let money stop anyone. So, Matt, I'm going to let folks try the NovaX report for only $29, the lowest price we've ever offered for a full year membership. This is 90% off the retail price. Plus, you're getting all of my reports for free. I believe those who join us today are setting up for the same kind of gains we saw back when I made my original prediction on Bitcoin, opening attendees up the chance at 25,351% profits, which means turning a $10,000 investment, Matt, into $2.5 million. Are these gains exceptional? You better believe it. But here's the thing. If you only capture a fraction of those gains, you'd still be making a bundle.
And the reality of it, Michael, is that it happened once and it looks to be happening again.
That's exactly right, Matt. And that's why I'm so happy to host this summit with you. I want to give everyone the chance to become a crypto millionaire. And remember, Matt, this is vitally important. These are still very early days in this new global ecosystem. A whole new future, a whole new currency is taking shape, changing everything for those who get in early enough to enjoy the climb to each new peak of profits. We know that big trigger events are right around the corner, how big hedge funds and pension plans are taking billion-dollar positions, how tens of millions of investors will soon be able to invest as easily as clipping coupons, how hundreds of billions a month could go into Bitcoin and the specific use coins, which can mean only one thing, Matt, prices continuing their valley to peak trajectory. It's the simple laws of supply and demand applied to a whole new market. And remember, Matt, there's only a finite number of Bitcoin and specific use coins out there. So prices have to climb to new peaks as the demand continues to soar.
And to me, that's the important takeaway here. Michael, this is great stuff. That's why you're extending this special invitation to join you at NovaX Report. It comes with complete access to your crypto circle, and you're giving away two reports that could turn ordinary investors to crypto millionaires, all for just $29.
That's right, Matt. I don't want price to be a deciding factor. So let me reiterate, this $29 deal is only being offered right now to attendees of this summit. After today, the normal cost will return to $299. But for those listening now, just click the button on the screen to try the NovaX report with all of the other benefits for only $29. Plus, this is guaranteed. If in the next 60 days you're not 100% satisfied with the results, just contact me and I'll return that $29 right away. No questions asked. And you can keep both of the crypto profit reports and all of the issues you've received on my website with my personal thanks just for giving us a try.
So folks, if you're listening, Michael Robinson has just authorized a special one-time offer for you today. Over the next year, you'll get 12 issues of NovaX Report, the best tech newsletter in the market. It'll include all the analysis and research on Michael's recommendations for hot new tech stocks every month, plus weekly progress reports and alerts when an action is called for. Act now and you'll also receive a guaranteed invite to the Crypto Circle, which takes you inside Silicon Valley's best thinking on Bitcoin and its next moves. You'll also get your two profit reports on how you could make a quick killing on cryptos. All this for $29, a one-time offer. And even then, you have a money-back guarantee. This is truly an amazing opportunity, and it won't be repeated. You really have nothing to lose for trying it, but you must act quickly. Michael only has 1,000 spots available today, so to claim your spot, simply click the button below. Michael, thank you so much for your insights and this special offer to our listeners.
You know, Matt, it's great being with you. Thanks for having me.
So to everyone out there today, I want to thank you for joining us. Now it's up to you. Click the button below right now. You don't want to miss this huge opportunity. So for Michael Robinson, I'm Matt Warder. Thanks so much for listening.